Welcome back to the channel. On September 26th, 2020, Tina and I decided to take part in the Ironstone Corona Concours. Now, we've taken part in the Ironstone Concours de Elegance before, and in past years, it's usually somewhere around 300, 400 cars, all beautiful classics. They don't allow hot rods in there. But it's a real honest-to-goodness Concours de Elegance. In fact, some of the people involved running the Ironstone Concours de Elegance also help run the Pebble Beach event. And it's kind of a big deal. They call it second only to Pebble Beach Concours. But anyway, we participated since 2011, and I didn't really want to miss a year, but they weren't having it this year. They kind of modified the event. I'll explain a little bit later in the video. But we spent about an hour driving to Ironstone Vineyards. It's a beautiful place, and we had a really nice ride. Of course, we had to get up really early to get there on time, and we arrived in plenty of time to get set up. I had spent the week before this event preparing and cleaning and detailing the coupe and getting it all ready to go, and that was actually for naught.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Last name?
Shin. S-H-I-N-N.
There you are, Paul.
Yes, ma'am.
Perfect. So you guys are doing the 10 a.m. route. So go ahead and take this red post-it note, baby. Stick it in your windshield. Go all the way down to the end on the left, and the boys will park you at the red flags.
All the way at the end on the left. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So like I said, I spent the week prior getting the car ready. So after work every night for many hours leading up to this event, I detailed this car just like I would any other time preparing for a Concours event, cleaning each individual spoke on each wheel, cleaning under the fenders, everything, and then they had us drive on powder and
gravel. We're going to be behind that British car.
Yeah. Well, it's a Model A.
So what, we take the tour right away?
Don't know. Let's see what happens.
Mr. Shin.
I don't know. This is the packet they just handed me with two masks in it, so we got extras now. They're telling us we have bad breath, I guess. It says, welcome. We're very excited that you're here to enjoy the 24th annual Ironstone Concours de Elegance Tour. We're grateful that we're still able to hold this 2020 tour, even though it looks very different from previous years. The concourse is all about raising much needed funds for youth ag education programs. Throughout the day, you would normally see and engage with the students. However, due to the C word, guidelines, they're unable to be here with us to share the agricultural projects, assist as volunteers, and raise funds for their programs. Especially this year, since they cannot hold events to raise much needed funds. If you would kindly consider a generous donation to support these students, they would be so appreciative. You bring money? We have Model A's. We don't have any. Below you'll find the route start times for the day. So the long route, I guess, is starting at 9:30 and 10:30. Short route, 10, that's us. Micro route. Didn't know there was a micro route. I guess if your car's really a weenie. For questions, here's who to contact. Upon your return, you'll drive. You will receive your goodie bag, box lunch, and drive across the main stage at Ironstone Vineyards, where every car is a winner. Participation trophies for all.
All right, Mr. Shin, what are you doing now?
Putting the sticker thing on. This is our get out of jail free card.
All right. Yeah.
Not very good at putting stickers on, but
yeah. You're putting something on your paint. Oh my gosh.
Yeah. Dedicated. That's a nice thing about a Model A. You can do stuff like this without guilt. There. How's that? Okay. Here's what we're doing. You ready? We're basically going back home.
Oh my. Where's it going?
Well, apparently we're going down Murphy's Grade Road. We're going out to Highway 4, going through Copperopolis, Copper Cove. We're going on O'Burns Ferry Road. We're going to get on whatever this is, get on 108. We're going to skip around Sonora, and we're going to come back through Vallecito and back up.
Wow.
That's a long drive.
Now, isn't one of those roads 65 miles
yes,
an hour?
Yes, right here is 65 miles an hour.
I thought I was remembering correctly.
Yeah.
Not a good idea with these old cars.
Yeah, why? What are you talking about? We'll be in everybody's way. That's so people notice you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's your prediction? How many cars will be breaking down?
I don't know. Looking here, I'm going to say 30%.
30%?
30%.
All right. There's a lot of really old cars out here. How many of them are driven as much as this one? We'll see.
Not that many. No. I suspect several of these are trailer queens. And yes. Yeah.
Everybody has signed their waivers and turned them in, yes?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
No.
No.
Okay. No lunch for you.
I didn't get it either.
I must have been
at the restroom at the time.
All right, while that is getting taken care of, obviously we want you to follow all the instructions that staff has for you while you're here, keeping everybody safe, shouldn't be too intrusive, obey all traffic laws. The groups, we're trying to keep you guys spread out a little bit so we don't have rolling chicanes on the local roads or kind of a pop-up parade. Use the turnouts, be mindful, other people are using the road, keep them happy. Then they'll be happy with our event.
Too bad there's some intersections where that can create a problem. I'd really appreciate that.
Shiny side up. See you at lunch.
So unlike previous years where the cars are all on display and the public is invited in, this year it's just the tour. That's fine. I love driving my Model A and I drive it every chance I get. And it's a lot of fun driving with other people, other car enthusiasts, even though I'm not really a car guy. I kind of like hanging around car guys. They're neat people. They're really nice. And plus, this is a charity event. We are raising money. So what the heck? Let's get the Model A a little dusty, shall we? Time to get out on the road and see what she'll do. But first, we had to wait our turn.
Hey, Tina.
Hey, baby.
The 1931 Sport Coupe is a kind of rare Model A body style. You rarely see one, let alone two, in one place at the same time. Finally, the tours got going, and we went ahead and videoed the first part of the groups taking off just so we could hear these fantastic cars going by. Some of them sounded so neat, some of them made no noise at all. It's just amazing. Seeing old cars in a museum is one thing, but seeing old cars on the road doing what they do, that's just so impressive. We were having so much fun watching the cars go by, but before you knew it, it was time to hurry back to our car because it was time for our group to leave. They broke everybody up into probably five different smaller groups, and I think we were the second or third group to leave. But anyway, there was about 100 cars participating in this event. They didn't want a huge traffic jam of old cars up on the road. Although there were a couple different tour routes, most of the routes did overlap, so we wanted to make sure there wasn't a huge traffic jam. Either way, we had to get out of Ironstone, driving about a mile total on powder and gravel before we got back to the paved roads. Then we headed through downtown Murphy's, California. If you've never heard of Murphy's, it's a really interesting little town. You get to see some of it here in a few minutes. I guess its biggest claim to fame was when Chef Gordon Ramsay came in for Hotel Hell and did an episode where he renovated the Murphy's Hotel. I think that's probably the most press this town ever got, but anyway, you'll see the roads around here. This is an absolute beautiful drive. We were really jazzed to get going on this. I totally get the enthusiasm. A lot of the people that own these really rare or really expensive classic cars, they just love getting them out to drive. They need an excuse, I guess, to drive them. Unlike Tina and I, we drive a Model A almost every day. We drive a Model A a lot. But anyway, these guys don't get to get out on the road very much. Maybe from the garage to the trailer to the grass to the trailer back to the garage. That's about it. So this Pierce Arrow right in front of us is one of those cars. We thought this car might not make it. It was having a little trouble, but then all of a sudden it would just take off and run good again. And they were struggling a little, but it seemed to kind of come back into its own. But spoiler alert, this car did come back to Ironstone on a flatbed tow truck. Just see. I won't get ahead of myself. This drive through downtown Murphy's was just so much fun. There were so many people out, and I had to kind of cut the video because there was a lot of faces, and I can't possibly get everybody to sign a release. But you'll get most of downtown Murphy's. You'll get to see what we drove through and see why this town is just so neat. And everybody was out looking at the classic cars, too. It was kind of a spectacle for the town. And now you know what a Model A car alarm would sound like. Roads, that's where it really got fun. This is what a Model A was made to do, right here. And man, these roads were so nice. They weren't exactly smooth, but the views were spectacular and the weather was awesome. Because of a little traffic in town, we had kind of gotten behind and the tour had gotten quite a bit in front of us, but it didn't take long. We caught up to that Pierce Arrow, no problem. They weren't exactly driving fast. I mean, we weren't either. But we were just enjoying the ride, and we were just a little quicker than the Pierce Arrow, that's all. But the car behind us, they caught up to us eventually also. And we got the group back together before long, and then we got to enjoy some fantastic countryside on a fantastic day. So nice. We've had so many fires in California. The skies have been so smoky. And all of a sudden, it was as if God knew that we were having the Ironstone Concours tour, and we were raising money for 4-H and FFA because the smoke cleared, at least for today. And we got some beautiful views of the mountains around us. Closer to the town of Angels Camp. I know it sounds like I have a big box of rocks in the trunk right now, but what happened was it was getting kind of windy. We were headed straight into the wind, and I don't know if you know this, but Model A's are not the most aerodynamic cars in the world. Lots of wind noise when you're inside a Model A, but it didn't matter. We were enjoying the views, and we were enjoying the drive. It was fun just watching all the cars behind us and seeing the great views in front of us. Everything was going great. We didn't know there was going to be a snafu pretty soon, but there was. But I won't ruin the surprise. The tour route also took us through another famous gold rush town, the town of Angels Camp. You may or may not know this, but Angels Camp is famous for jumping frogs. Yes, you heard right. Mark Twain wrote a story called The Jumping Frog of Calaveras. In the story, Calaveras County was really into jumping frogs. That was the big thing that got people out, and that's what they did every year. That was their thing. And somebody cheated by putting lead in somebody else's frog. Well, you wouldn't do that these days, but still, every year at the Calaveras County Fair, they jump frogs. And up until fairly recently, schools were actually out that entire week for frog jump. It's that big a deal. But this gold rush town of Angels Camp is just so cute. The buildings are amazing. Even the old movie theater here, everything is just so historic. I can't imagine a better route to take this tour, but as it turns out, not too far down the road from this is where the big snafu happened. I'll save that for later. The sidewalks in downtown have bronze plaques embedded into the sidewalks of the winners of each year's frog jump, so they're immortalized forever. As the tour progressed through this beautiful countryside, we decided, you know what, let's put the video camera down and just enjoy this tour. And then we got complacent.
So right now, you can tell everybody why we're going the other direction now.
Oh yeah. You might notice we're going the other direction now. Yeah. The reason is, the car who was leading the tour, they blew by our turn and just kept going, and everybody just follows. Of course, you're on a tour, you're supposed to follow, right? Well, so did we, thinking, okay, well, we're on a tour, all right, maybe there's... No, there wasn't. They missed the turn. So I figured it out, and I said, all right, I'm going to turn around. So I turned around, we're headed back, and we're going to be back on the path in just a moment.
Yep.
They'll figure it out.
One group of tour mates that was at least smart enough to go, hey, wait a minute, something's wrong, and they stopped to figure it out. Not us. We had just kept on going, didn't even stop. It cost us about 10 miles each way, but that's all right. It was a great day to drive the Model A.
The good news is we're back on the right path. The bad news is the right path is really, really bumpy.
I know, people always say Model A's were made for these roads, but I don't know, maybe I'm getting soft. Our bodies weren't made for this. This road was rough. Second gear almost the whole way for many, many miles.
Sure is pretty though.
Yeah. Glad I greased the suspension last night.
I know.
We used it a lot.
I may not have 18 left, but we didn't do that.
Turns out Tina wasn't that far off. It was just over a 2-hour tour.
Up to us.
Yay.
All right, I think we're home.
And we're home. Ready to go across the stage?
Ready to drive across the stage. We made it.
Yes.
Hi there.
Are you two vegetarians?
Thank you
so much.
Excellent. Thank you. Got him.
Sorry, we have more stuff for you.
Oh, okay. Well, we put it back here then.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Now that's a dedication.
Thank you so much.
You guys.
Thank you.
Wow, that's a lot.
Paul Chan with a
1931
model A4. Yes, indeed. Perfect. 1, 2, 3. Nice.
Good?
Good to go. All right, thank you. Chris?
Loot.
Look at that. Stop at the coolant puddle.
At the coolant puddle, yeah.
Thank you.
It was so weird to see these huge grassy staging areas empty. Normally when we're here for a Concours event, the grass areas are just packed with cars and people. But no, not this time. Well, because of COVID-19 restrictions, we had to stay far apart. But they got all the cars in and immediately over the stage, gave everybody their lunch, and then sent all of us up to the hill up above. And we all kind of staked out our little spot in the grass area and had our picnics. It was a great day. Some of these cars were just stunning. And even though, yeah, okay, there was 100 cars that started the tour and maybe 80 cars that actually finished the tour and showed up again, it was still a great day, so we just had to kind of sit back and unwind and debrief just a little
bit. So here we are sitting on the grassy knoll up above the stage at Ironstone, and we made it. So it was interesting, as you saw in the video, whoever was leading our group wasn't watching the map.
No, they were not.
They were not. So we said, you know what, we're turning around. We're going to get back on the course we're supposed to be on. We have yet to see any of the cars that were in our group, and we've been here pretty close to an hour. So we were a good 10 miles past that turn.
Easily.
So I told her, I said, all right, I had to make the decision first. You got to decide, okay, I'm going to commit, I'm going to turn around, and then, you know, we're going to head back and get back on course, right? So, okay. So then I'm just looking for a place to turn around. What I know I don't want to do on a 2-lane highway, very highly traveled highway, is pull off to the right and then try to find openings both ways and make it. I don't want to do that. So I was looking for a spot where I can turn left and then just kind of flip around and then quick, easy right. There's the Volkswagen Bug. That was another. Okay, finally. So how long has it been? About an hour and 20 minutes.
Good. How the heck did you pass us?
I turned around.
I knew you guys were lost, so I turned around.
Oh, we were following a guy in front of us.
He was lost.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah.
Where'd you guys go?
I don't know, a long trip. Made it.
Made it. That's good. Yeah, come on in. Join our video. So now, really, there's nothing left to do. We have our ribbon. We had our lunch. We can pretty much do whatever we want now.
Gonna go check out some beautiful cars that still run.
That still run, yeah.
Yeah, the place is pretty big, so I don't know if they're just really spread out. But
no, that's just not that many back yet.
Yeah, okay.
Because we're all in the grassy area here.
Yeah, I think we got a lot more to come back still.
I think so. Yeah, there's a lot of people out there still. That big yellow car we were behind.
In
fact, the car that was behind us, it almost rear-ended us a couple times. That car is still out there somewhere.
Oh, man.
Yeah, hopefully they're all right. Hopefully they didn't rear end the guy in the yellow car in front of us, because that was an expensive car.
Not a cheapie like this
Not
one,
a
huh?
cheap, no. All right,
classic
so
car on a beer budget.
I guess we're going to go look around at some expensive cars.
Yeah, and we'll share it with you.
Yeah, we'll share. So watching from far away, we saw the last few cars come across the stage. Of course, it was late afternoon, it was getting kind of hot, so we walked around and checked out some of the amazing cars that showed up for this event anyway. Now, different than a regular cars and coffee type event, you don't see hoods up unless the cars actually broke down.
At a concours event, no, the cars are displayed in their classy form, especially some extra classy cars, like Cadillacs and Duesenbergs and Packards. I just can't get enough of this. I guess I was born too late. I should have been born during this era. No, instead, I missed out on the 50s and the sock hops, and I missed out on all that. I just kind of got to relive it through my grandfather's eyes, I suppose. Thank God these cars are still here for us to enjoy. The lines, the styling, the beauty of automobiles. Automobiles really are an art form. It doesn't, none of this, you know, eye of the beholder stuff. Some cars are just beautiful. Some are just eye-catching. Some remind you of your youth. Speaking of youth, I took my driver's test in one of these. I was 16 years old. I could barely see over that hood. I was scared out of my mind, but it was the only car available to me at the time, and I needed to get that all-precious driver's license, and somehow I made it. This Volkswagen Beetle was fantastic. It's pretty close to a Model A, if you think about it. I interviewed the owner of this car. Look for that in a future video. This is a really neat car, and he had a lot to say about it. It was fascinating. Admittedly, this event was nothing like the typical Concours d'Elegance, but that's okay. They did what they could, and you know what? Everybody had a great time. It was just a tour. There wasn't cars on display like there was in previous years, but it didn't matter. This event was still totally worth it, and we're so glad we went. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please tune in again, and God bless.